Hello and welcome. This tutorial will try to easily explain what malware is, how you get it, and how to remove it for free. Short for malicious software, malware refers to software programs designed to do damage or other unwanted actions on a computer system. Malware consists of viruses, worms, Trojan horses, and spyware. Malware can delete or steal sensitive or personal files, allow your computer to be remote controlled for evil purposes, and bombard you with pop-up advertising. You really need full antivirus software, like Microsoft Security Essentials, installed in addition to running this software. If you don't have antivirus software installed, please watch this video to install it now. Malwarebytes Anti-Malware is an anti-malware application that can thoroughly remove even the most advanced malware. Malwarebytes is intended to find malware that other antivirus programs generally don't find, including fake security software, adware, and spyware. In its free version, it allows manual scans to remove the malicious software, and a paid-for version that keeps the malicious software from infecting your computer in the first place. The most common ways for your computer to become infected with malware is by opening attachments from people you don't know, or for that matter, ones that you do. In many cases, someone you know will have become infected, and this will cause their computer to send out malware to everybody in their contact list with titles like, "You have to see this," or something else to get your attention. When you click on this email attachment, it infects your computer and repeats the process. Let's start out by downloading the free version of Malwarebytes Anti-Malware and getting it installed on our system. Open a web browser like Internet Explorer, Firefox, or any other web browser of your choice. Click on the Windows Start Order, All Programs, and in this case I'll select Internet Explorer. When the web browser opens, enter the URL malwarebytes.org without the quotes and press the Enter button. This will bring you to the Malwarebytes homepage. Click the Download Free Version button. Upon clicking the Download Free Version button, it'll open one of its download mirrors. In this case, techspot.com. A mirror is a website that agrees to provide server space for others to download an application, like Malwarebytes in this case. This is using techspot.com for the mirror, but you may have to adjust if another mirror is chosen. Find and click the Download Now button. If you're using an up-to-date web browser like Internet Explorer 8, then when the web page changes to try to download the Malwarebytes installer, for safety reasons, it will prompt you with a message stating to help protect your security, Internet Explorer block this site from downloading files to your computer. Click here for options. This additional security measure is done because in many cases malicious software will attempt to automatically install software intended to do harm. In this case we are trying to download Malwarebytes, so we're going to allow the download to install. To allow our Malwarebytes installer to download, let's right click on the tan security warning and select Download File. You'll now be presented with the File Download Security Warning window asking, do you want to run or save this file? If you're having problems just running the file, you can click the Save button, download it to a location like your Documents folder, and then run it from there. For ease and the purpose of this tutorial, we will just click the Run button. The download is only 5.86 megabytes, so it should only take a minute or two to download if you're using a broadband connection. You will now get yet another security warning with the Internet Explorer security warning window asking, do you want to run the software? Depending on the version, it should be named MBAM setup dash whatever the latest version is .exe. The publisher should always say Malwarebytes Corporation. Click the Run button. If you have User Account Control, UAC enabled in Windows Vista or Windows 7, which it is by default, Then you will receive a new window entitled User Account Control. You will be presented with the question, do you want to allow the following program to make changes to this computer? It should list Malwarebytes anti-malware for the program name. Click the Yes button. Now we have the Malwarebytes installer downloaded and ready to install on our computer. The Select Setup Language window should be open. Select the appropriate language and click the OK button. The Setup Malwarebytes anti-malware window will open and guide us through the rest of the setup process. On the Welcome to Malwarebytes anti-malware setup wizard screen, click the Next button. On the License Agreement screen, click to select the radio button next to I accept the agreement and click the Next button. On the Information screen, click the Next button. On the Select Destination Location screen, leave the default installation location and click the Next button. On the Select Start Menu folder screen, leave the default folder name and click the Next button. On the Additional Tasks screen, leave Create a Desktop icon checked and click the Next button. On the Ready to Install screen, review your choices, then click the Install button. After a quick installation, you will see completing the Malwarebytes anti-malware setup wizard screen. Ensure that both Update Malwarebytes anti-malware and Launch Malwarebytes anti-malware are checked, and click the Finish button. Updating Malwarebytes anti-malware. It will let you know the database was successfully updated from an older version to a newer version. In this case, version 4052 to version 5023. Click the OK button. After the installation and update of the Malwarebytes definition database, the main Malwarebytes anti-malware program window will open on the Scanner tab. Now, there are two versions of the scan available in the free version of Malwarebytes anti-malware. Sometimes the computer will be so slow because of active malware running in memory that it'll take forever to run a full scan and remove it. If this is the case, you should choose the option Perform Quick Scan, which will quickly scan the memory and currently running programs, removing whatever it finds. Reboot the computer and then run a full scan. It might be necessary to run several quick scans to get all memory resident malware before you can run a full scan. Click to select the radio button for Perform Full Scan and then click the Scan button. You will be presented with the full scan window showing all drives in the system. Based on the icons, you can see that the top A drive is a floppy drive. The C drive has both an icon depicting a hard disk drive, and it also has the Windows logo showing that its drive Windows is installed on. The D drive shows it is an extended volume for Windows. Drives E, F, and G are all CD, DVD, or virtual DVD drives. I will ensure that both C and D drives, being permanent hard drives, will be selected for scanning and click the Scan button. Depending on the speed of the computer and the number of files to scan, this can take hours. As it scans, in addition to the time elapsed section, it will show the item currently being scanned. As it scans each one, it will update the number of objects scanned. And as it finds malware, it will increment the section, Objects Infected. Once the scan completed, a new window will open stating, "The scan completed successfully." Click Show Results to display all infected objects. Click the OK button. Click the Show Results button to display more detailed information about the threats detected. By default, all the threats will be checked for removal. Click the Remove Selected button. Malwarebytes will go through and remove each infection. You'll be presented with a log to review if you wish. You'll always get this message stating that all selected items have been removed successfully, a log file has been saved to the logs folder, and that your computer needs to be restarted to complete the removal process. Would you like to restart now? Say yes to reboot now. Let's open Malwarebytes anti-malware again. If we click on the quarantine tab, we can see the listing of all this malware that's been found on the system in the last scan. We can click the Delete All button, and this will delete everything that was in the quarantine. Now, the next time you plan on doing a malware scan with Malwarebytes anti-malware, you'll want to make sure that you run a manual update to make sure that you have the latest definitions. To do this, open Malwarebytes anti-malware, click on the Update tab, click on the Check for Updates button. Here we receive a message saying the database was successfully updated from version 5023 to version 5049.